talking about gun control, because Donald Trump just successfully banned the bump stock. I must be reading this teleprompter wrong.
The federal ban on bump stocks goes into effect in March. It's a victory for the Trump administration, who made it happen without passing any new legislation through Congress.
Huh. Well, okay, didn't see that one coming. I'd say it came out of left field, but I think this is an entirely different ballpark. My gun rights activist viewers might be saying, don't worry, the Supreme Court will start swinging around that Second Amendment and wipe this thing away in no time. But it was just reported that the Supreme Court isn't going to touch this one, so the ban stands. Today we're going to try to answer the question, wait, what just happened? So first, what is a bump stock? Well, it's not a gun, if that's what you're worried about. It's an accessory that you can put on a semi-automatic gun, or a gun where you have to pull the trigger every time you want it to fire a bullet, which who can be bothered to put in all that effort? And instead uses the recoil of the gun to continue to pull the trigger for you. For those of you listening to this in podcast form, I tried to describe it, but for those of you on YouTube, here's the most relaxing video of a person describing how a bump stock works on the internet.
Use the gun's natural recoil to bump the stock back and forth between the shoulder and the trigger finger, which lets someone fire at a rate much faster than a human could possibly pull a trigger.
Wow, that is the closest you're gonna get to a conservative ASMR video. Okay, so I place the stock on my shoulder, pull the trigger, and then it keeps firing bullets. That innovation might sound mundane, but whoo boy does it juice up some of those semi-automatic weapons. Yeah, wow, there is no way I could move my finger that quickly, much to the disappointment of my girlfriend. Sorry, Mom and Dad, it was right there. So this brings us to the larger question. How do you go about banning this product? I mean, what we're talking about here is essentially a stock that, on its own, is only dangerous if you're really good at throwing things. Well, this regulation comes down to the ATF, or the Bureau of Alcohol, Tobacco, Firearms, and Explosives. Basically, they regulate everything that you need to have a perfect 4th of July. They amended the regulations on December 18th so that they say bump stocks fall within the definition of a machine gun under federal law. As such, devices allow a shooter of a semi-automatic firearm to initiate a continuous firing cycle with a single pull of the trigger. Now, I know I'm not stopping any of the comments by saying this, but I'll say it anyways. This is not my opinion. I ripped that statement right off of the ATF website. Now, you might have heard what I just read and said, Steven, this doesn't sound like a Trump thing. This sounds like an ATF issue. But nope, this came right from the top.
Just a few moments ago, I signed a memorandum directing the Attorney General to propose regulations to ban all devices that turn legal weapons into machine guns.
Always knew a New York elite was going to come to take our guns away. Just wasn't expecting this one. This is no throwaway issue either. The ATF says that people in possession of bump stocks have to either destroy or surrender them by March 26th. The website even has suggested methods, including completely melting, shredding, or crushing the device. That might be a problem though, considering most people don't live next to a foundry, industrial shredder, or other place where you can host the climactic fight with a Terminator. I mean, you tell me I have to melt a bump stock to nothing, I'm gonna need to open up a few windows. On the other hand, you can also abandon bump stock type devices at the nearest ATF office. So yeah, wow, we really aren't messing around with this one. Now that we know what's happening, the final question on some people's minds is, legally speaking, what the heck just happened? Because, interestingly enough, this isn't being argued as a Second Amendment case, but rather an executive power case. Because, and I can't stress the oddness of this enough, but the executive branch just skipped over Congress altogether and told the Department of Justice to start ordering people who own bump stocks to either destroy or surrender them. For a long time, we saw.
At the time, the ATF already determined in 2010 that bump stocks couldn't be classified as machine guns because there's no mechanical function.
Yeah, again, it's just a piece of plastic, not a machine gun. All Trump did was say, hey, this piece of plastic turns a gun classified as a semi-automatic weapon into a gun that could be classified as a machine gun. So, that piece of plastic is a machine gun. And if you disagree, take it up with Trump, not with me, because that's the exact argument that was made. This case that re-registering bump stocks as machine guns should require congressional approval started at the federal court in Kalamazoo, Michigan. Federal Judge Paul Maloney upheld the change in classification. He specifically said, Congress restricts access to machine guns because of the threat the weapons pose to the public safety. Restrictions on bump stocks advance the same interest. The Gun Owners of America lobby trying to appeal this decision to an appeals court in Cincinnati, but that motion was denied. In all caps and bold, wow, they weren't messing around. Their decision specifically said, the government concedes that the plaintiffs will suffer irreparable harm. However, the public interest in safety supports the denial of a stay pending appeal. Now the Gun Owners of America lobby were ready to make that appeal happen and got on the horn with the Supreme Court. Unfortunately for them, on Thursday, March 28th, also known as today, the Supreme Court declined to take on that appeal. Wow, that makes this the single largest ATF seizure of private property in American history. So depending on your politics, it's either thanks Trump or thanks Trump. Because he really is the person to either thank or blame for this new ban. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the right of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring. Remember to give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.